du er væk.
Ja, det var det sådan set.
Jeg havde dem, der kom ind, mand.
Velkommen til pressekonferencen.
Welcome to the press conference.
Landstræner Kasper Hjulmand.
We have our coach Kasper Hjulmand and the star of the match, Thomas Delaney. Kasper, can you say something before we start with the questions? Yeah, first of all, big credit to the Czech Republic. I think we started the game off very, very well, and we did what we worked on. After that, we started the second half a little bit more difficult. They invested more in the game afterwards. I think the Czech Republic has put a lot of honor in this game. It was a tough game, just as we expected and as we feared. In the second half, we had a lot of space, but we couldn't make any long passes. So we hoped that a 3-1 goal would close the match. We had some chances, but we didn't succeed. So all credit to the Czech players. Also our players, Kasper did well, Yannick did well, everyone did the best they could in order to stop the Czech passes. They really pressured us, but sometimes you have to win games that way. We have some games that we won pretty comfortably with 4-0 and 4-1. But this is also a way of winning a football game. So I'm very, very proud to be in a semifinals at a Euro with this team, which is a great team. And once again, thanks a lot for the support. The wings that our people gave us are so important, and we are so happy that we could give something back to Denmark and to everyone who watched the game from home. And I know a lot of people celebrated a lot in the country, and they're proud and they're happy. And thanks a lot for the support and all the credit to the team. We're gonna start with the question. Click on the green hand, and you're gonna come through.
This is Emmanuel Baranguet for Agence France Presse. It's a question for the coach. Do you feel that after the dramatic incident with Christian Eriksen, a lot of hearts of football beats for Denmark in the whole world, in Europe? You're kind of favorite underdogs, if I can put it in these words. Do you use it as a motivation, as a coach? Do you tell it to your player? Do you feel it?
Yeah, I definitely feel it. I think the whole world of football understood that second and the days after the fundamental things in life and in football, the fundamental values of football came through right at that second, at that moment, those days. There's so many other agendas in football, but I think we all remember why we started to play football, what values football is based on, and we had a reminder of this. I'm still thinking about Christian every single day. He should have been here. We are happy that he survived, but we carry him all the way to this match and all the way to Wembley. I think about him all the time, but I think we all understood in football Europe, maybe in the football world, what football is basically. The values and principles of football came through, and I think maybe we're a symbol of it. I couldn't be more happy than that, because I think the team showed it without being told that this is the way you should act, this is the way we should do things. So it was just unbelievable to see this team, how the reaction was, how much compassion and love they gave each other, but also the Danish population. And And we are just happy and proud that we can maybe just remind ourselves why we play football and what football can do in the world.
Thank you, Emmanuel.
We have a question. Vi har et spørgsmål fra Steffen Grunemann fra BT. Værsgo, Steffen.
Question from Steffen from BT.
Ja, tak. Hej. Der var mange fede detaljer i den her kamp.
There are a lot of great details in this game. But I don't think I've ever seen any sexier assist than Mæhle's on the 2-0 goal. Can you describe that? How did you experience it?
Jeg var henne efter kampen og spørge Mæhle, om det virkelig var med ydersiden, for jeg var ikke helt sikker.
I asked Mæhle if he really kicked it with the outside of the foot, but he didn't really remember, but damn, he really plays well.
Der er momenter i vores spil, hvor vi er virkelig, virkelig dygtige, også i dag, selvom det ikke er vores bedste.
And we are at a very, very great level. Today wasn't our best game, but I think that all the goals count in this game. Kasper, something to add? He did that to Sufal, one of their best players. And I know that Jannik, he keeps the ball a little bit, and then he makes sure that Sufal flies away, and then he passes the ball. It was just amazing to see. All the talk about the talk about having to play with the left leg in order to be in that position doesn't really make sense. Mads from Ekstrabladet.
Kasper, nu i semifinalen sidder du med en følelse af
you're in the semifinals. Do you feel that you can go all the way now? And we saw that in the halftime you put on that lucky sweater, so you got to be a little superstitious. Since then it went south. No, it was because I was in white, and then the players told me that sometimes they thought that I was a player. So it was just so that the players can distinguish me from their teammates.
Starten med at blive noget overtro, så prøver jeg at gøre hvad jeg kan for at skære det, fordi det er noget pjat. Men
if I catch myself in with some superstitious thoughts, I usually just stop that. But of course, that sweater is going to Wembley. Despite trying to avoid superstitions, but it will be on the bench. Question from Mikkel Ritzau.
Tillykke med sejren.
Congratulations.
Du får lov til at være helt fri ved det her første mål.
Thomas, you're all free when you score. Can you remember when that happened the last time? Is it something you talked about before the game? We worked a lot on our set pieces. We have a coach who goes through it with us at every training session, and it wasn't the plan for me to head that ball. So that's how well prepared you can be. But it's great that we finally did it, and against such an opponent who has proven how they can play. It was a hard game, and the next one is probably going to be just as hard. But knowing that we can do something from set pieces is nice. Who was supposed to head the ball? Well, I can't tell you that. I can't reveal too much, but it was a great feeling. Next question, Patrick from TV2. Congratulations. Thomas, you're going to Wembley, Spain, Italy, Denmark, England or Ukraine. That is a great company. According to Instagram, everyone thinks that Denmark are winning Euro. What are you saying about that? We have a goal. We wanted to go to Wembley, and what a journey that has been. And for us, it doesn't matter who we're gonna play. We're just very proud to be here. And my generation grew up with the legend from 86 and 92. Not that we're in the same place, but it's nice to see the happiness we give to people. It means a lot. to us, and it's it pushes us further. Søren from Politiken.
Tak, jeg har simpelthen smidt mine høretelefoner væk i kampens afslutning. Jeg håber det går.
I threw away my headphones. I think it's okay. What did you say about the 1,500 Danish people who came all the way to Baku? Do you think there are going to be more at Wembley? Of course, we're very grateful. The crazy fans, they booked the tickets hoping that they would, or not hoping, or thinking that they would go back in quarantine when they came back to Denmark. And we know that we would have many, many thousand people here if it were possible. But we know how much it means, they know how much it means that they came all the way here to support us. And once again, it felt like we owned the pitch, that it was our stadium. And that is one of the reasons why we can use so much energy there. And we are very happy about the support we're getting from Denmark. I've received a lot of photos from cities in Denmark. So, I hope that many thousand fans are gonna be able to come to England. But no matter what, we know that we have a lot of support. But I just hope that the fans can be there. Thank you. Anders Bold.dk.
Hi, Kasper.
Congratulations. As Delaney said, he wasn't the one who we're supposed to head. It looked like you had been practicing that. Can you describe it? No. It's something we have worked on a lot. We have extra coaches with us who have been working very hard on that. I don't want to talk too much about this. It's something we work very hard on. And sometimes when you're in a situation, you just happen to be free and execute. And I think we had some really great set pieces, and it's just amazing that it succeeded today, because we knew that they are very, very good at set pieces, and they trusted that they would be the ones with the successful set pieces. So it's really great that we opened the game that way. BT, Steffen for BT.
There
are a lot of celebration after the game ended. What happened with Højbjerg who broke down? Hjulmand, you talked to Simon Kjær. What did you talk about? I don't remember.
Jeg tror vi snakker lidt om at som de næste.
I think we talked about
hvordan vi
how proud we are and how well we've done. Oh yeah, I remember. We talked about how we would proceed. So you're just chit-chatting about that. I think I'm not really sure that I remember correctly. What about Højbjerg, Delaney? What happened with him? Or were there other emotional players? I ran over to Pierre because it looked like he needed a hug. And I think it was hard for us, and I think all the feelings came out after everything we went through. It's a little surreal right now to be here after everything that happened. The game was very hard. I felt so sorry for all the substitutes, because it requires a lot of work. So we all hugged each other and celebrated.
Tak, Steffen. Vi tager Patrick fra TV2.
Thank you. Patrick from TV2.
Jamen, jeg vil bare høre, om I har
I just want to hear if you talk with Christian Eriksen, and if you want to share it with us. I haven't had the time. I didn't even look at the phone or anything, but I can just say that I think about him all the time. And I thought about him during the game and after the game.
Ja, jeg må sige, jeg tænker rigtig meget på, at han måtte gerne have været her
so, og have løbet rundt. I keep thinking how amazing it would be to see him play there. He's still a big part of this team. And he's a big part of our road to Wembley. That team is not something we built overnight. He has been a part of the team for a very long time. So I think about him all the time, wish he were here. And I'm sending a lot of greetings to him. And he's a big part of this result. Thomas, anything to add?
Jeg tror Christian skrev noget ind i gruppen her efter kampen. Altså han var stolt.
I think Christian wrote last night that he was very proud of us.
Christian har altid været en vanvittig vigtig del af det her.
And he has always been a very very important part of this team, and he still is. He has been our best player for many years. And we, of course, we carry him in our hearts. He should have been here.
Det er noget vi kæmper lidt med.
And it's still something we're struggling with.
Det gør mig glad, og det gør de.
But making him proud is something that makes me happy.
Emmanuel from L'Equipe for the last question. Emmanuel?
Your team has an offensive style, and do you feel your players are tired after 5 games, and maybe Thomas can give his personal feeling?
Yes, we go full out every game. We're tired after every game, but I think, you know, the good thing about playing a lot of games is that you get in a rotation where it's all about match day minus one, match day plus one. You're in a little bell in around your head, and we're not tired. Not tomorrow, not the day after that. Today we can be tired, but we have a long way to go, and it's. In every game, I think we have shown that as the game evolves, we are strong, and we'll bring that attitude into the next round again, and have a great belief in that as the game develops, time will be on our side.
Yeah, I think we want to attack. So after this match, I think Italy has just attacked a little bit more than us, but from there we're second. We have a style of play where we like the intensity and we want to go forward and also defend very quickly and aggressive. And we use a lot of players. We switch. We use the 5 subs in our games to keep the intensity high. I think we lacked some of that intensity today. Obviously, we could see that. That we were matched. Czech Republic did a great job, and we suffered at the end. But what a great way to suffer and defend to the last end. But I'm very proud the way we want to play football, and we try to attack and always score the next goal. And that's the aim.
Vi har fået et enkelt spørgsmål her til sidst. Det er Anders Sten fra Tipsbladet, der får lov til at afslutte pressemødet. Værsgo, Anders.
Last question from Tipsbladet.
Ja, tak for det.
Thank you.
Den går I lige ud til, kan I høre mig?
Ja.
Do you hear me?
Ja, yes. Den går I lige ud til, til dig, Højer, fordi jeg kunne forstå på...
It's a question to you, Højer.
Skulle spørge til det. Der var en dansk fan, der fik...
There was a Danish fan who... whose rainbow flag was taken away. And I just wanted to hear what you thought about that.
Yeah, jeg tror, jeg bliver nødt til at sige, at jeg ikke kender sagen til fulde.
I have to say that I don't know what happened exactly. I've heard about it, but I don't know any details about what happened. So I would rather wait until I get more information than we're going to take it on the phone.
So we can sagtens ringe kort efter her.
I got some info from UEFA, so we can just, I'm going to call you after this. Thanks a lot for tonight, and see you at Wembley.
skal du huske din fine kvæl. Tak. Kan du turn it off? Tak. Det er mig, der tager.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you. I'll just leave it here.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah.